I basically bring them.
What's it doing?
People come up with strategy, I come up with
implementation.
So I'm really more of a behind the scenes kind of
person. Yeah, so that's
inside
your
time.
So what do you do otherwise here in Taipei?
低一点点。
他不用，因为他转速率还是会低，所以你这边的设备是。
Joshua 也还没，有几个没看过。
Now I'll be back in Paris next week on Friday.
That's right.
嗯，对，好几个
没看
过。
对。可以吃吗？
啊？
对。
He's coming.
So after 8 years of being on the road, it's like moving back towards the Boston area.
Oh, where are you
from?
没，直线转播是不是？
I was at a house
that's
kind of like
north of there.
哇。
But
你用 Facebook 的直播就好了。
对啊。
Near Boston.
好慢，
因为他30秒停的，直播都是这样，
所以
另外一边看有顺就好。
对啊，都会顺直，都会顺。有要是哎，我应该把它贴。
你要先开始哎。
英文表示
live 的。
真的要开 live 吗？
可以把名称
讲一下。
Or maybe, how about we just go ahead and stay up in Montreal for... Actually, how about this? So where's the room?
Hey, Bob, I'm going to go. So I was thinking about buying the Brand 的那个 full license. If we want to open the app, 的话
打
完就好了吗？他就存了吗？
看人，
还
有
感觉他存
面板了。
然后网址，网址
新的，
哪里可以拿到网址？
是吗
？Oh, this is a Brunair for a satellite tracker.
你这个好像就是你在你的官方页，
回来
，Really？
那个我是后来，因为是在加拿大嘛，那我回来是主要是想认识一下。对的，然后看看你有没有兴趣，
可以在你自己的那个手
做一些
个人页，个人首页。
All right, I'm sending out a live stream, so maybe people can watch online. They can now.
Cool.
哈
哈哈哈
哈。
比
较少。
Just the
video. Also the video.
没关系，我上个月。
Where's the video? Where are you filming from? From there? Oh, okay.
From the camera.
I think we need to get a better video setup
for that.
Because
in
Taiwan, you
need
to
go to
different
groups
to
watch.
Hey, cool. But I want to first see the Zhuhou, because they are also a Zhuhou
company. SC.
Zhuhou agency.
欸，他串流结束之后，你可以事后再边做一些编辑。
Is this YouTube live? Is this YouTube streaming?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.这沙发直接翻过来，
翻过来
就。
我
用这电影。
啊，我什么都问一下。
在你的右边啊，
水平垂直，水平垂直，
垂直翻转，水平翻，是水平翻转才对。
啊，没关系啊，哎，
嗯。
Good evening.
More exercise.
我们说另外一个运动。
Yes.
重置变换呐，没得。哦对，然后拉伸，对 ，OK， 这样就很简单了。
没有，他还是那个，
哎，那应该是。
不说中文很多了 you know, 很多了说法文英文跟
中文可
是我
好过分啊你们这样欺负我
什么
你是用直播吗
对啊对啊对啊
直播好了
哎，这个 OVA 今年的 OVA 看了啊，今年的 OVA 看
了，看了，但是 OVA 很短。
对啊。
OVA 应该是那个，
听说只有三话而已。较狠的是，我去日本为了他的那个重置的 BD， 我花了三万块钱。
好的。
就直接进去跑这边，出发。然后还顺便买了他的那个设定集。没关系，反正七月会有新作。
啊？
不是这一部，那个
yeah,
同一个作者的新作。
你说他的下一部、啊？
对。
跟什么？
那
什么？
还是
对。
不灵耶？
那个我看还不错。
借一个位置。
好，那你那个电脑拿进来。
这样 ，OK， 没有挡到。
那、啊、你网址是要放到哪里？已经放了吗？
现在有在，你要帮我转发，我放在活动页上面了。
放在活动页吗？
就是 Facebook 的活动页上面了。
我看一下哦。
哦，这一部是导演阿姨说《圣斗士星矢》，然后呢，他在欧。
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Yeah, it's like at least the whole thing, even after 15 years, he's still like. Still in Beijing. He still doesn't speak Chinese good enough. But that's okay.
My family is here.
Gathering.
My aunt.
You made
a t-shirt
for me. No, no,
yeah. If you're the spouse, you're the friend, whatever. No.
但是你要去抓日本。
I pay other people to be my teacher.
It's easier for us.
那个好像也没有做过吧？
我问你问过复制连接。复制连接。
啊，按九按。
九按吗？
你可以把它开到那个。
用分享连接分享，你直接用 YouTube 开就分享连接。
不是，我觉得
Line
有趋势，只是说按九按不能。
不是，我一直说你只能用 YouTube 的分享功能。
She's so cute.
Oh.
我这是哪一个？我看不懂。
Cool. What did you do? Did you solve it?
Yeah.
A problem.
Yeah. Oh. Didn't
sure, really?
In a minute or so, yeah.
You just rocked that?
哇，你再去旁边就好了。啊，在这边吃打我太啊太多了，我到旁边那边。
没有
啊，就是沙发你都可以坐，就对对，不然想
自由一点，
不想干扰大家专心的。
我先帮我打旁边好
了。
好
啊。
有点麻烦。那个，可以啊。为什么你现在要开声音？
就是在看一下。等一下开始就声音就关掉就好了。
不是因为等下开始吗？
好，
跳 delay 再播一次。
我一起想的。
啊？
跳 delay 再播一次。
So who's the leader here? Hmm? Who's the leader here?
Leader.
谁老板
？Who organized it?
Actually, I do.
Okay,
I see that.
I think most people are already around. So we don't have a pretty strict schedule. So we just start with Michael. Michael is from Accelerant. He's the CEO. So I met him at DrupalCon Asia in India, and finally he told me he's in Taoyuan, in Taiwan. So we don't know there's a Drupaler in Taiwan. I don't know before. So I'm very welcome to Michael to join our the very first Drupal meetup at Taiwan, right?
This one?
Yes.
So this is the first?
You're
for you.
Oh, for me! Yeah! So, let's welcome Michael. Give us a talk about maybe we always compare WordPress, Joomla, and Drupal. So he will tell us when or how or why to choose between WordPress and Drupal. And then James. He was also with me at the DrupalCon Asia at India. We spent a lot of time in the DrupalCon. So he will show us some maybe photo and experience about how the Drupal dog running the whole conference in India. Okay, so let's start. Welcome, Michael.
So this is better than a blue screen of death because it means it's not a Windows machine. Is there like a presentation that goes with this? It's blue.
Yeah. No. Can you replug the?
Oh, is that what's going on?
Try to reconnect again.
Okay.
It was on.
Am I mucking it up somehow? It was looking. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys are awesome. So let me do this.
Oh, by the way, we are already online.
Yeah, so if you go, everybody in the world knows it.
We use YouTube for live.
I know. Last person came, has to open the door. He was the last.
Hey, how about you give the presentation and I will run downstairs because I haven't done it.
Sure. I can do that.
All right. That's actually kind of blinding. So I'll come back on this side. So anyways, guys, hi. I'm Michael Cannon. I'm the chief, I was about to say chief people officer, but that's like a job title from like 3 years ago. In the meantime, I'm actually now the chief operating officer. Basically, that just means I'm a glorified business manager, which is cool with me because, frankly, high lofty titles means that you don't get to spend time with people like you. And really, for what I like to do is I like to be connected to the people that I'm working with. So anyways, I'm here to say Dajia Hao, and let's try to figure out when we can work with Drupal, when we work with WordPress. First off, Niman Shuo Zhongwen Ma.
Yep.
Okay. Okay. All right. So, I'll say, while most of the time for the day job, I'm, like I said, as a business manager, really kind of, I sort of see myself more as a sales and marketing director these days. But really, when I'm at events or things like this, this is more of what I am. I'm the photographer. I'm the guy that goes running around with the camera. I got the big camera, got the big lens, and I go snap, snap, snap. So that's kind of... Photography is the way that I give back to open source. And actually, this is just small. This is such an easy photo after DrupalCon Asia. This is just a few hundred people. And it's fantastic. I actually had a sidewalk right here. I was just like, everybody stand there. Get off the sidewalk. And, you know, it just this photo just comes out. It's wonderful. But James can tell you. And, oh, my gosh.
Chris.
It is Chris.
Yes.
Did you cut your hair?
A little bit.
Hey, that's what it is. You look good. So anyway, James and Chris, they can tell you how big DrupalCon Asia was. It was gargantuan. So maybe he'll show that photo. But anyways, things like this happen with teamwork and really You gotta have a team to make things happen. So let's talk about WordPress Drupal. Honestly, I don't code Drupal. I have used Drupal in the past, and frankly, I would go like, what the heck is this crud? But I have to say, that's changed since Drupal 8. Now Drupal 8, I'm like, oh my freaking gosh, this is so cool. There's so much that you can do with this. But not everything that you want to do is really applicable or needing the power and capabilities of Drupal 8. So for those other times, which is really where I ended up starting shifting my clients from years back, from these high-end content management framework systems that's called Typo3, I started shifting them over to WordPress. Because out of the box, since about 6 years ago, WordPress is covering about 80% of all customer needs in about 5 minutes. Now, of course, there's vagaries within that, and that's something that we will get into to talk about this evening. But really, that's my background. I've got kind of no development experience. I'm just a user on this side for Drupal. But on WordPress, I've been killing some code and that stuff for... I think I actually go back to like WordPress 2.0. But overall, development-wise, I've been coding since 1984. So that means I was already going to school before you guys were... Actually, I was coding with you before you were born, probably. And because he's got gray hair, we might be almost on the same age. Alrighty. Need that little glass of water. And
water?
Yeah, please.
Water, tea, coffee?
Water,
whiskey. Wine.
later. We want to get through this in 20 minutes, right? So as you guys know, WordPress is really a fantastic system right out of the box. It covers most common needs for blogging, for corporate sites, you know, doing things like lead generation, organizational communication. You know, it is used by a lot of folks. So, you know, that's the good thing. You know, it's an easy solve capability. It's often considered number one because it's got like 74 million sites, 42,000 plugins. You know, actually, I have one plugin that has 60,000 installs active. It's like so freaking cool. I kind of disliked it because just as I was nearing 1 million downloads for one of my plugins, they changed it to active installs. And I was just like, I'm sorry, 60,000 is not as cool as seeing 1 million. But anyway, so anyways, I do have some experience in this stuff. And WordPress's environment is growing by leaps and bounds. Ah, so not wine, but avion. So good. So really, why WordPress is currently chosen as the most common content management system that's out there is really coming down to two reasons. You know, first reason is because, you know, it's hitting everybody's needs. You know, there's a high overall ease of use, whether you're looking at content creation or even some simplified customizations to the systems. You know, it's a pretty easy system to hack, frankly. It's got a quick installation, you know, it's tons of features. Like I said, you know, solves 80% of everybody's needs out of the box. So you don't have to go worrying about it. You know, these days, it's such an easy system to work with. If you got clients that get stuck on the system, they can just get support for it easy, which is always a nice thing. And of course, when they get bored with the design, they can just go out and buy a new design for $5. So that's always nice. And of course, supports multiple authors. You guys, if you have questions along the way, please ask me. I kind of like those question things. And if I'm speaking too fast, because I feel that I am, slow me down.
Okay.
So, in comparison, or at least a perceived comparison of other content management systems against WordPress, most all other systems are considered number two. And really, it's just come down to because perceived awareness and really, you know, the engagement of these other content management systems that's out there. But frankly, you do a quick search for content management systems and it's like you can come up with, say, 24 different frameworks and content management systems that even frankly I hadn't heard of until I was putting a little more research into this, and just as an idea. And I'll say CMS did made simple, come unique, Greek 5, Express Engine, Frog CMS, get simple, Habari, Jekyll, sorry, medium movable type, Shopify, Satomic, Dexpattern, Tumblr, Tapply, Weebly, Wix. You know, so there's a lot of options out there besides WordPress. But WordPress is, you know, kind of the most common just because it has the greatest awareness that's going on. But really, what you got to be considering is WordPress being the number one choice perceived, but is it the number one choice really for you and your needs? And that's something that you have to decide. So while WordPress is really a great system, right out of the box, you're going to start running into issues with it. Now, first off, one size does not fit all, is because WordPress does such a fantastic job for lead generation and blogging or corporate communication sites. It's not such a great thing for actually running applications or running headless or being able to do mobile API integration. Yes, maybe in WordPress 4 with some changes that's coming around in the API structure, that you know it might be able to take that jump. But at this point in time, it's not a one system for everything. Okay.
Headless
as in another term is being decoupled, and being decoupled means that what you see on the front end, actually say you have a back end that's running WordPress or Drupal. But what you see on the front end is actually like a Node.js or a React front end. It's entirely JavaScript. So that's, we have a decoupled system. And decoupling is actually really rocking cool, because when you have a decoupled system, say you have this core CMS or core application framework, you can be porting data out to mobile devices, out to different kinds of feeds. You can be porting it out to all kinds of different XMLs that can be getting translated and whatnot. You've got it going out in APIs and other RESTful things. And of course, to be serving a website. So decoupling, headless, really, really cool. In fact, we just delivered legacy.com. It's frankly a death site based out of the United States, but it's a top 50 website in the, on the Webcast 50. And we did it in a headless manner. So backends Drupal, frontends Node.js, React. Some really cool stuff. Because really, once you actually truly separate the front end and the backend, your imagination has no limit for the front end. So there. Really, at the end of the day, though, where WordPress is really kind of falling short is WordPress kind of starts failing when you start getting into the larger organizations and enterprises. And that's really because you've got so many different kinds of integrations with like enterprise resource planning, just-in-time management, things like that. Yeah, it's when the acronyms start coming out, WordPress probably doesn't quite fit in anymore. So start to kind of bang on WordPress is the tad bit harder, but still, I love WordPress for majority of what needs to be done. Something to keep in mind is WordPress does have the most installations. It really is like the for the top 1 million websites in the world, it does power over 50% of them. Okay, so it is a very, very capable system. But when you start getting at the other end of the spectrum, when you start getting down to what's the top 1,000, 10,000 websites, that's when Drupal is outpacing WordPress by over 2-to-1. So a way to look at it is, well, WordPress has more websites serving 10,000 visitors a month, but Drupal has the most websites that's serving 1 million visitors a month. So that's kind of the starting point of when do you want to be choosing WordPress and when do you want to start to be choosing Drupal. It's like, hey, if you got a low volume site, make your life easy, unless there's super complex requirements going on, just go WordPress, okay? You know that you're going to be scaling and performance issues. You got millions, 100,000 visitors. You're going to be really going after the 1 million. Then you better start looking at Drupal or some other high-end performance systems. Love it when these screens go around. So I'm not just talking out my butt about WordPress powering up the top million sites and WordPress, or excuse me, Drupal powering up the top 10,000, 1,000 sites. You can actually be able to pull this data out of Alexia. I mean, you need to have a paid account, but again, this is where basically, you know, top million sites averaging say like 10,000 site visitors a month, and then down here you got like a million site visitors. Your gray area where you really are going to have to start figuring out the hard part for figuring out when to choose WordPress or to be choosing Drupal is when you're in this gray area. You know, so like you're around 100,000 visitors a month. It's like it's going to be a balance. It's like, does WordPress's ease of use, does it outweigh the performance concerns that you're going to be having to run into? Or does Drupal's performance for serving 100,000 users, is that enough to overcome maybe some of the ease of use issues that you have going on? Are you going to be having other integrations with other systems? Are you going to be wanting to expand into mobile or application territories? Yeah. So really, when you're down here, yes, WordPress. When you're over here, Drupal. In here, this is when you better look at your requirements from the client and really figure out what's important. And this is where it's pretty critical to
know. What was the CQ5?
Oh, I'm sorry. I actually thought this was concrete, but it's Communique. It's Adobe's Experience Manager. It's actually a proprietary system. But apparently, CQ5 is the most popular, say, proprietary system within the publishing world for powering websites. So I was kind of surprised that .NET and some other systems weren't in there. Anything? Other questions? Wow, we're getting a lively crowd in here. Okay. So, as I was kind of mentioning, when you get to the higher traffic sites, more complex, that's when you want to start looking at your Drupal options. Right off the bat, I mentioned performance. Performance is pretty key when you're running large-scale websites because customers or site owners, they don't like it when their website goes down because frequently other people start complaining. So you really want performance. Drupal is heading up the performance with like built-in caching, scalable databases, and frankly, pretty advanced tech core. You know, that's meant for performance right off the bat, especially when you're dealing with Drupal 8. Again, I'm like, wow, this is so cool. You know, there's always the debate about security between WordPress and Drupal, but frankly, Drupal, the way that it's built and with its own built-in security tools, Drupal takes the lead with the security options. You have a more extensible, scalable network. You have mobile accessibility right out the box with Drupal 8. You also got multilingual, multi-site capabilities, and of course, a lot better third-party integration capabilities with various APIs, REST, JSON, and SOAP, and of course, user access management. Yes, WordPress has got some pretty simple stuff, but Drupal, right out of the box, allows you to go into, groups and roles, which is pretty cool stuff. All right, so at the end, it really isn't about Drupal versus WordPress. It's really what fits best for your client needs, and it's what fits best for the business needs, you know, whether it's yourself or for the clients that you're working with. And so, keep in mind, it's Neo Winti Mount. Oh, come on, okay. All right, fine. Anybody here working with Drupal 6? Wow, I am so sorry. So what are you guys doing with Drupal 6 being into life? Because Drupal 6 isn't being supported even for security since February 24th. How are you guys managing that?
Maybe you have more.
Okay. Wow.
We tried to upgrade to the latest version, and then we tried to tell the client that there is no upgrade
anymore because we can show them the upgrade page.
Yeah,
it's all not supported.
Yeah,
already. But I don't have not much. I don't have much site built on Drupal 6.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe James do. You don't have the security.
Wow.
You don't have the security with security problem with the Drupal 6.
Wow. Wow, I haven't heard of Drupal 5 site.
I got we got Drupal site run Drupal 5 to Drupal 7.
Uh-huh.
And now we have Drupal 8. So we have.
So they are migrating.
Okay, that's good. Okay, all right. Some of you guys in back also are working with Drupal 6. How are you looking to migrate? Are you looking to do a go to 7? Are you looking to go to 8? Or are you just going to hope that there's not security issues? Are you just going to throw Drupal 9 out there and try it, or what? How are you guys going to work with Drupal 6 now? She just smiles. He just eats. He smiles now too. He just chomps. Okay, all right. So I got another question for you then. So James just mentioned Drupal 8. Anybody else working with Drupal 8 then? Hey, there's one!
I've done some work on Drupal 8.
What have you been doing with Drupal 8?
Writing it?
Seriously?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I am humble, man. Okay, just out of curiosity, how many commits have you got to Drupal 8 then?
I don't know, maybe 40 or 60, somewhere in that range, I think.
Okay, I think back's on my humbleness. No. What?
I didn't quite reach the top 100 this time because I did a lot of coordinating rather than actually writing code.
Actually,
he's the lead for the
mobile
response design group.
Fantastic. So actually, I think I probably pinged you as part of social outreach then back in January for being part of the. Anyways, we were writing about mobile global capabilities of Drupal 8, so I might have done some tweeting and things like that. So I might have tagged you, but hey, thanks. Actually, I'm sorry, it was James? No.
John
and then Chris and then James, okay. Yeah, actually with John and I, it's like we have coded, and it's been fantastic for giving back to the community, but actually giving back to the community in other ways, like doing the coordination work, really is as equally important as doing the code, okay? So if you've got an artistic streak, hey, help out with the design. If you can write or you can edit the documentation, contribute, please. It needs to be done. Actually, a little secret. Japan is having troubles adopting to Drupal, frankly, because the documentation, there's not really a lot of documentation for Drupal in Japanese.
Documentation?
Documentation. You know, introduction to Drupal.
Sorry, it's an inside joke.
Yeah, okay, well, yeah. documentation really is key. But anyways, if you happen to be curious to do contributions back to Drupal or other open source programs, it's not just about code. There are other options. You know, as I mentioned, I'm a photographer. I get back to the community that way. Yeah, it's, I love it. So, any other questions? Concerns? Alright. Can I go into my secondary spiel then?
What?
I have a second spiel. It's like
okay.
A second presentation. But it's like, this short! But
of course.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Alright, guys. Okay, so that's me being the guy from Accelerate. Now this is me being the camera dude. Peace, man. Oh, you want my photo? Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, wait a minute. On. Okay, all right, come on. Give me some love, man. Oh, okay, thanks. All right. So anyways, if you don't mind, I'll take a few photos tonight. And if you guys are really cool for it, I will actually do a group photo. If you're open for it,
yeah.
Maybe I can take it in about an hour. What time is it now?
7:40.
Okay, so actually maybe about 8:30. So about 8:30 if we're going to do a group photo, I'll do that. And then I have to admit after that, I've got to head home because I'm doing baby making this week.
Yeah,
except for the weird thing is I don't even get to be there for the baby making. You know, I've already contributed. But I've got to go home and babysit. So. All right, so the next thing is I've got some stickers here. It looks like this young man's already hijacked his, so don't take them. So I've got some Drupal stuff. I've got some Burnin'. I've got Darth Vader.
I got the Taj Mahal, baby.
Okay, and if you're really hardcore for Drupal, I got some Drupal loving. But anyways, and of course some GitLab stuff. So come up, grab stickers. If something in particular goes away and you really, really want it, you know, just ask me. So beyond that, so yeah, see, yeah. So photos, group photo at 8:30. Anybody here doesn't want their photo taken? No? Oh, you guys are so awesome. You're not stuck up Europeans. Sorry, guys. Sorry. No, actually, kind of a new thing is despite we've got mobile phones going on all over the place and security cameras everywhere and Facebook and everybody taking pictures of themselves, there's more and more people that don't want to have their photo taken. And so as an event photographer, it's getting harder and harder for me to just be able to walk into a group, walk up to a group and say, cheese! And it's like, I pull up the camera, about to pull the trigger, and then a person runs, I don't want my picture taken. Then why are you in the middle of the group smiling? The pains. You know, leave. You know, some of them are actually pretty cool. Okay. So anyways, that's it. Anyways, I'm here. Bye. Yeah! Bring it up! Next.
Okay.
Oh, one more thing. When are you guys having a like Drupal camp, Taiwan, Taipei?
You see it?
Somebody make sure you get my card or make sure you hook up with James or Chris and let me know because I will try to make sure I come back to Taiwan about that time on some other travels and come shoot the event.
Yeah,
okay.
And run a team. I noticed, like,
notified 2 weeks
before. I know.
做那个 sticker 交换， 所以我就把 没贴到的全部带过来， 想要可以过来拿， 我就会起放前面。
Alright, so you got some cooler stickers than I got.
You know, we have stickers
exchange
changing box.
Yeah,
so
right.
For people to exchange the stickers.
Yeah.
不过每一种 我只拿了一个， 齁， 所以拿完就可以。
It's actually partially because of you guys.
因为我们一直在活动看到这个东西， 然后， 这个是活动的那个手册， 可以转到去看一下。 然后剩下的话， 我觉得比较好玩的应该是这一个， 待会后面会讲到。
Drupal转子表， Drupal的转子表，
他告诉你没， 就是那个每种什么角色的人，你需要哪些技能，然后这个技能修完之后，下一届可以往哪边移动这样。 然后好像有少了一两张吧。
我先打个岔哦，就稍微介绍一下那个 James， 他就是跟我一起去主播岗。那这边应该可能还有人还没有认识的，就是他是跟我是前一届的主播的站长，就是主播台湾那个论坛的站长。那他这边带的这些资料就等一下你可以跟大家介绍那个大概是什么样的东西这样。
其实我很多东西，很多也我也不知道是他什么东西，就是了。
然后那有前任的站长，现在还有现任的，
现
任的
现
任
在
委员，就他喜欢在这里，
他在那边玩鸟。
我讲实话，你本来就在玩鸟。
对，那等一下，建这边介绍完，
就先开推个。
OK， 那建不是等一下这边玩的话，我们今天还有一位新的朋友，就是那个后面哈维帮我举个手，就是他是甘地达内特的朋友，然后他等一下会他自己主动跟我通知说，今天这个活动，因为我在 Hackerspace 这边 manager 发，那他那边会有一个介绍说怎么样用甘地达内特的那个hosting 去装 Drupal。所以有一些不同的平台，大家可以看看来使用。那现在就是吧，换键子再开始吧。
Twitter， 还有一个 Twitter 的连接，这是临时的。因为 Michael Cannon 说要让大家看一下活动到底有多少人，所以开照片。
那个下面，
需要这个 space 出场。
That was actually one of my team.
据说这个量好像是一千多人吧，弯烧着。
那詹姆斯在哪里？
大家找一下我们这台湾团都在里面，大家可以努力找。
好，我找到了，就
找到比较白的鬼了，
比较白的，
完全找不到，
皮肤比较白的。
对啊，
有点难哎，有点难哎。你可以先去。
杰尼找到了。
没有，我老花。
老花看远了可以啊。
对，你可以先用。
我们在前面啦，然后
一下就知道了。
Charles， 他好像在这里。
我在这啦，
我们在这里吗？
这个是我。
哦，看到，认得出来，
好 ，OK， 回 slide， 感谢。好，因为。这次的话就是跟大家简单分享一下，这次出国看 Asia 的一些经验。对，那如果你觉得这个距离不太方便看的话，这边有 QR code 是这个简报的网址，所以你可以直接扫它去看，可以就直接用手机看什么的之类的。OK， 好，那我们正片开始，来下一页。好，这次呢基本上算是一个临时的。就突然收到，有直播看 Asia， 然后第一次在 Asia 办的时候我们就冲了，然后我跟 Chris 两个讲了半天之后我就开始订机票了，然后所以这是我基本上只去过日本三次，然后香港一次，所以这是我第一次转机，第一次到印度，然后第一次参加外国人的讨会，还有第一次12小时那个桃园机场，早上12点回来，中午12点。
他从日本回来，隔天马上去。
同一天，
有过12点，
凌晨0:00，然后回到台湾落地哦，然后坐接驳回台北，然后再换个行李箱，然后再继续出去，然后东西就直接丢家里了。好，下一页，
标准的商务人士，
我们就去了，去印度，
这
大家应该看不懂吧？
这
是西游记，
西游记，
台湾画家画的，他把西游记恶搞，西游记那个他在这里嘛，就是那个是不同，好 ，OK， 下一页，当然就穿这样，好，所以下一页 ，OK， 这是我们这次的台湾版，好像是不是有少一个在里面，就帮我们拍照，
优下，
对，他不在里面。
对，
因为基本上那个第一天那个开场结束之后，大家就开始冲上台上拍照了，所以我们当然加入强烈之一。不过左边比较可怕，大家就看得到。好，下一张。好，总之呢，因为这是一个 DrupalCon 的分享，所以先跟大家讲一下我们一些去那边看到的一些东西。不过因为它的资讯太多了。那我的英文也不是那么好，所以我只讲的，我就讲几个我比较有印象深刻的东西。那待会后面的话，还有一个连结是我们 大家去台湾团这边去的这些人你们有做一个共同的 HeyPayPay， 那大家可以直接进去看 Note 这样子。好，那下一页。OK， 那第一个就是 Note， 这个应该有印象，理论上，但是基本上 OK 啊，在大概五分钟之后吧，就是开讲五分钟之后我就睡着了，所以后来大概去挖了一下那个大家在推那个推上面讲了一些什么东西这样子，那大概看了一下，因为有中间我醒来几下啦，那有几个东西比较有印象，
我打他。
啊，对，看到关键字
了。一个的话是他有提到有一个东西叫 Webless Use Experience 的概念。那这个基本上其实很简单，就是大家一直在讲的，就是说在做网页的时候，其实基本上你现在应该要思考的不是从 Web 出发，而是从 Mobile 出发的一个想法，就是你不是就是想的画面是那么大，你应该是先想在手机状况下怎么用，然后再开始往上增加这种状况。OK， 那另外的话呢，他有提到一个技术，我后来去查一下，其实这个技术看起来应该还蛮变态的，但是我不知道到时候实装状况怎么样。是他一个技术叫平台的技术。那这个技术的话，它基本上我在早上的时候在那个公司有大概查了一下，它是说，它会把网页切成好几个区块，那它可以让网页在显示的时候先吐有快取的那一些。那没快取的那些，像是可能使用者的资料，因为每个人都不一样，这些东西这时候才用 BigPy 把资料吐出来。那这时候因为快取的那些可以直接先吐，所以网页第一开始瞬间 吐出来那个网页的秒数可能就会只剩 0.7 秒之类的。OK， 那这个技术的话呢，他那时候讲说在 8.1 的时候会放到核心里面。那目前我看他好像已经是 release 到 RC2 了，对，所以等他正式出来 看效果如何，然后。基本上，待会因为有 三个，那你有看到 QR code 啊？这是每一个 session 的那个简报连结。如果想直接看他们完整简报的话，可以进去。那这张照片的话是战场，就是那时候那个开幕一结束 ，GIS 在台上，大家要做的第一件事情就是跟 GIS 合照，所以我也加入了，只是
被切掉。很高，
很矮。旁边的人都比我高啊，撞到就会变这样。这还没有切过，这是完整的图，我只剩下这样。好，下一张。好，那这个的话就比较有印象，他是在讲 Drupal 的版型，他讲版型开发。那其他部分就是讲了一些 Tweak 的技术的东西。那还有他就是有提到他们有尽可能缩减了 DIB 的使用，因为在 Drupal 7的时候，你会看到它就是 DIB 一层包一层一层包一层，那到最后大概就是。
波动学
对，没错，而且是超大型波动学，是开大学的那种等级。OK， 好，那他有讲到一些东西，那我简单提一下，就是说，因为这基本上是我写的笔记啊，所以基本有点乱，就是了。那他有讲到一个东西是说，他在 Drupal 的时候，你现在开发的时候，你会基于一个副版型在开发嘛？对，那他是说，如果你们一旦要做要设一个副版型的时候，千万不要去拿我们以前常听到的 7 啊，或者是那个 breaker
bracket
OK， 就是那些已经有直接可以使用的那些版型，我想不起来怎么。
我
就怕
他讲，我才知道你们在讲什么，
发
现我什么东西、
啊。对，就是你要以那个他的 base scene 做版型，或者是直接就把 base scene 设 force， 他就直接用核心的。核心的 tweak， 那因为这样子的话，它就不会掺杂到一些像什么一些 class 之类的东西，比较一些有的没的 detail 的东西这样子。OK， 然后还有就是我好像有听到是说，他说 7 这个版型好像不会在之后应该不会在 maintenance 这样子。然后另外的话，因为每个版型在基于副版型的时候，你会当然它也会去继承副版型的一些 CSS， 但是。以前在 Drupal 7的时候，它继承什么就只能照用，然后再写个 CSS 去 override 它，用 CSS 的权重去盖掉它这样子。那它好像在 import 的时候，你可以写说，我继承这个副版型，但是我不要副版型这些 CSS， 就它就直接不会去，它就直接不会去把 import 进来这样子。OK， 那我觉得比较特别，应该说对未来开发比较有效的话，应该是后面这两个东西，一个是 kit。它是 tweak 的一个 function， 那这个 function 的话是你在Drupal 里面都有一个档案叫 cities.php 嘛， 不对，好像也现在多了一个另外一个档案叫做 service.yml。OK， 它是做一些网站的一些设定，因为 service.php 通常是放一些像资料库啦等等的设定。那它还有另外一个比较类似 config 档的东西叫 service.yml。然后你可以在里面有一段是写 tweak 的部分，然后你可以把它的 debug 功能设成 true， 就把它打开。那这时候呢，你就可以用 kind 的方式把它，就是把某些的资讯印出来 ，OK。然后或者是说像可能你希望那个知道某个地方它可以用哪些版型档案的时候，它这边就它就会直接再用注解的方式，然后在 HTML 里面开始写嘛，这样的状况。然后另外的话，以前我们还有一个做法是说，我们可能要自己客制化样式的时候，然后我们会希望，比如说我希望某个栏位后面再印，那前面先印其他栏位。那以前的做法的话，可能是先把那个栏位拿掉，自己再补印之类的。那他现在可以就是写说，我印的时候我会需要某个它里面的那个某个项目 ，OK， 它因为它通常是一个 variable 嘛，那我就说我会需要，比如说 body。然后这时候我在另外一个地方之后，我再把 body 印出来，这样这个动作。然后这好像是他还有提到，他一个推荐的版型就是，好，那下一个，
补充一下那个 kind 应该是他要另外装，他其实就是我们在 seven 常用那个 eval 的 DPM 的工具。那在八的时候，他 kind 可以做到更多，而且他可以配合那个前端 tweak 的可以做。
原因是因为 D 片它使用那个 JavaScript 不是 JavaScript， 它的 PHP library 非常非常旧，对，几乎已经没有在维护。
Kind 现在是比较新的。
说到这个，我最近有一个痛苦的东西，就是大家写出 Java 的时候，最好不要再用 DPM 跟 VRDump 了，因为它只会告诉你机体过稿位，因为它会把整个 Apache 印出来，你就死了。
有啦 ，Kind 这个
一个就行了。
Kind 这个我。那时候在讲这个的时候，就是说用那个可以做 debug 会比较好，比较容易卡，
它会比较赖。
对。对
OK， 那我是现在好像看到它那个 Symfony 有一个新的东西，但是目前的 Drupal 手一直卡档，用不出来。叫做它有一个东西叫 VAR Dumper。
Dumper。
VAR D U M P E R， 中间没有空白。它是 Symfony 的一个，算是它的一个元件。然后可以装起来，然后对一个元件，一个外挂套件装，它是新闻里用来做 VR 大本的一个元件，对，但是它本身有人写模组用，但是不知道怎么讲，一直打不开，所以我在试。OK， 好，那先下一个。好，那这个的话呢，是它是讲标题叫做 Make Your Code Do Your Job。OK， 那它简单来讲，它是在讲一些 Drupal 7的一些新的东西啦。OK， 那他是在建议说你在开发的时候，但是开发站哦，正式上请不要这样干哈、哦，把你的那个 Hello Message 开成 EO，
全开
，你就才知道你到底哪里没写好。对，因为以前我们习惯就是只开 Hello 就好了嘛，反正没 Hello 就无所谓。但是他是建议你开到 EO， 他就才知道有些什么，比如说像可能某 Array 里面某个东西没不存在之类的。OK。然后呢？
我讲一下，你如果不开 EO 的话，你万一是 PHP 的语法错误，它会直接给你喷500错误，什么东西看不到，
你也看不到错误，
就白画面，
它就是白画面。但是你不是 error 这样子，它就你不会进 error。
如果白话就是它 HTTP return code 是500，然后你根本不知道干的会发生什么事情。
要回去 tail 啊。
好 ，OK， 然后再来的话呢，它是建议说。我们 function 以前习惯是写说，我们就写 function， 然后 variable 一、variable 二、variable 三嘛，这样子。那他是建议说 ，variable 现在写的话，你最好是在 variable 的前面再加上你希望这个变数进来就是什么的格式。
嗯，
比如说像他现在就是 int， 他现在就是 string， 他现在就是某个 object 之类等等的，就是要做的写的比较严谨这样子。
写程式的习惯要改，以前那种变形从变数的东西就不要再去改。
对，他那因为以前我们习惯那个 PHP 7，我们会习惯那个它的变数，一下是字串，一下是文字，然后一下又变成 Apache， 一下又变成 Boolean。那他是建议说写的时候就直接写说进来就是什么东西。然后另外的话就是 function 在 PHP 7的时候多一个东西，它可以在 function 的最后那个。标记说这个 function 它的 return type 就是你除了要求别人进来是什么东西以外，你可以告诉别人我出去就是什么东西。比如说 我回传就一定是一个不灵值这样子，那别人收的时候一定不会收到不灵值以外的资料这样子。那这有一个好处是在于说，因为这样子的话，以前我们是等于说回传出去，然后大家也不知道为什么错误，只好把 RBI 的 dump 出来看嘛。但这样子的话，系统就直接告诉你，因为你传回传的格式错误了。OK， 好 ，OK， 那下一个。那 OK， 那我比较有印象就大概是先。那如果大家有想要再看就是其他的 session， 因为我们是分散跑的，所以每个人记的东西都不太一样，然后你又记到其他 session 的一些笔记。那想看的话呢，这边有 QR code。那这边也有文字啊，如果你刚有开 slide 的人，其实 QR code 全部都可以点，它本身就是 link， QR code 全部都是 link， 你可以直接点。对，如果你已经用手机开的话，
你都可以贴到那个今天活动那边，可以把它贴一下。如果后来想
就 我到时候再把 slide 贴出去，因为 slide 本身已经是 open 的。
嗯，
对，它就这样子，我们有每个人大家轮流都有分开写，然后还有写说每个一层到底是哪些人去的，对，大概是这样子。OK， 那先不去。好，下一个。OK， 那前面大概是一些技术的东西。那再下来的话，因为是第一次去印度，所以跟大家分享一些这次去印度还有研讨会的一些照片。好，下一个。好，这是我第一次做转机，就是香港转机点。我第一次知道，原来我转机不需要出关，我还带着台胞证去了。安全起见，虽然说 Chris 跟我讲说，不用，但是我还是安全起见带着，因为我听说有同事曾经被关在那边，所以我就自己乖乖带着，然后台胞证取了，然后其实在里面走一走，然后就里面就有柜台可以用这样，对，而且还可以跟他讲说，我们本身那个什么行李要加过到哪里，然后他帮我们全部全部去。好 ，OK， 下一个。
你没有直接从台湾挂到印度？
有讲，但是去那边还是有确认一次，避免他挂错地方什么的，然后。有一点很微妙，我们坐的飞机去程飞机跟回程飞机都是大型机，但是去了回来很慢，但是去的都是这个样子。这已经是准备要起飞喽，这不是那个刚开战胜机，就是准备要起飞的样子哦。
是在台湾出去还是从香港？
香港出去的，香港到印度，我们是从香港转机。OK， 好，那下一张。然后这个是我们已经要进。开那个已经到印度了，然后我们要开始玩研讨会走进去，所以我们已经进大学，然后在大学里面，
在 IITB 里面
有牛，
对，然后有牛，而且不止一只，还很多，而且不止一只吧？
可能大学有畜牧系吧？
我不晓得，
一定有啦。
然后我们还看到一个很奇怪的景象，我看照片我不知道有没有放，它是那个他们那边也有像台湾一样，就是那种比较就是那种房车型的，但它停在一个自己搭的铁皮下这样。很特别，然后下一张，好，我拍舞了，这是那个现场开始报道的样子。他们报道方法是直接就是看你的那个信的第一个英文字母是多少，就直接照位置去拍，然后你就刚才开始照，这样子。不过没有塞车，我不知道为什么，台湾通常这样就塞住了。
他应该有先算过了，
应该
他有分
对。然后这边是领 T 恤的，然后如果有什么需要的话，就是去 help。然后像那个 Charles 跟那个 Albert 他们有领到那个奖助金嘛，那他们就是有第二天就去 help disc 做帮忙这样子。对，好，下一个，好，他们的吃饭，对，我们通常就是饭的大家随便拿，就是领便当嘛，他们是领餐盘。就因为那个我们那个第一天拿到之后，里面就有很多的那个类似邮票的东西，就是你可以撕下来这样子，然后你是拿着那一个撕下来，然后拿去给他，他就给你一个盘子两个碗，然后还有餐具这样子，然后去装，然后他会帮你装，你不能自己拿，他会帮你装这样子，对，好，下一个，然后这是他们很有名的嘟嘟车，去外面坐嘟嘟车要小心。我们瞧了好几次，还没赢过。
你们利用 meter 吗？
啊
，by meter。
Yes, by meter.
Yes, the sign is already down, so it's on meter.
Oh, okay, you just got it.
Also,
yeah.
One time we have by meter, but it's start from 100.
The meter was already on before they got in.
Yeah. And we say we need a countdown read meter.
Yeah.
And the guy says, it's already on, it's already on.
But it's already 100.
You get out and go find new meter.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Shut up.
Where did you guys stay?
Meluha the fan.
How far away?
It's just like a 2.5 kilometer. It's on the Central Avenue.
Okay.
Okay. 这个是就是刚刚讲的战场。我在加入战场之前，我先从外面拍了一张。就是呢，第一天那个开幕结束之后呢，大家就冲上台去找 Juice 抓着合照，然后呢，所以就变成这个样子，合照。
Yeah.
对他。
Yeah.
还好他算高。
He's like 6'4".
He's like half a head taller than you. 从刚才看就知道，我站在他旁边，我大概可以躺在他胸部这样。我第一次体验到什么叫强有力的感觉，真的很高。所以还好他比较高了，所以大家拍可以拍。如果他比较低，大家就找不到。
对，被相机拿起来就可以拍了。
对，所以看每个人这样拿起来开始了嘛，然后我就拿着我的平板加入这样。
这应该算少人的时候了吧？不然还更多。
这个是第一批已经上掉了，然后第二批，因为第一批最进去的时候最可怕，大概淹了那个他们舞台的一半。对，然后后来我们决定要离开之后，旁边有一大群好像是橘色衣服的。整团找他一起合照，就他就被拖出去了。
进香团，
差不多找到下一个。然后这是印度沙画。然后其实我们在第一天企业日的时候，我们就看到他正在做。对，然后这是因为第二天，就是他第一天很晚才做完，所以我们第二天就去看到他。但是看到他的时候，他基本上已经被补了好几脚。然后我记得好像 TKY 的脚在这里吧。
你一定要把它讲出来，就不要
讲在这里。他补到，他不小心踩到。
听说要补充一件事情，就是说他们其实印度在画这个沙画的时候，通常画完之后就把它摧毁掉，
就会摧毁。
然后我 maybe 是他的借口了，他说这叫无常，对无常的概念。
我总之还是可以看到这个样子啊，特别是上面。OK， 好，下一张。好，这是他的那个点心，某一天好那个好玩把它拍下来。对，但是大家可以再看这上面是什么东西，你完全猜不出来，它只是样子很特别，但是其实是口感跟刚才完全不一样。我要先说这绝对不是蛋，
是凤梨吗？
它是一个很像，
应该是糕点类的，
全部都是甜点。对对对对，这个比较特，这个比较正常的，这个有点类似那种。炸薯块什么东西？好，这个的话他们最多，几乎每一餐都有。
那什么？
它是一个很像海绵球的东西，大概那么大。
嗯，
很像海绵球的东西，然后吸满了糖水。
超难吃的东西。
吃下去像是吃棉花。
它感觉就很像，你知道吗？咬下去，然后瞬间糖水在你嘴巴喷出来，然后就开始想办法把棉花咬掉，这样。
然后那种感觉是咬那一口，绝对会发。
我光听我牙根就软，
然后这个其实它是一个很滑、很 Q 弹的东西，就是你咬下去之后，基本上它是两个非常完整的弹开的感觉，对。好，下一个。
两个非常完整的弹开。
对，它不像蛋，就是咬下去会碎掉这样，它不是，它其实是甜点的。好，然后这是我们后来有一那个第一天晚上我们去了 after party。对，忘记
是第二天啦。第二天礼拜
以活动来讲，第一天，因为应该说活动主要天的第一天啦，因为我们还有一个企业日，对对对，
session 的第二天嘛 ，session 第二天，
你们两个知道是谁醉了？是假？
第二天吗？
对啦，对啦，
哦，session 第二天，哦，第二天结束，不好意思，我醉了。那session 第二天结束，算是活动第三天。对，因为它是企业日嘛，第一天、第二天，然后那个还有那个 spring， 然后我忘记知道是谁约的，有一个人在上面就开始晚上 tweet 开始说，我们今天晚上去 after party， 然后在什么位置这样子，然后大家就到这边集合了。 对，然后我们就刚好跟那个一个日 Kia 上嘛
，Kia 不是 Kia 是那个新加坡的 Kia，
Kia， 然后还我记得
还有那个
日本的那个
东京的 Ken
的 Ken 就去吃，然后我们是在酒楼上，对，然后这是我们吃完的餐具。
我想
吃
完，
因为我们已经吃完了，而且要拍照。有没有？这很好吃，这饼干很好吃。然后他们最推的是这个每天都吃得到。
看起来有点像那种干掉的葱油饼。
嗯，有点像，就是不加任何料的葱。
就是烙饼嘛。
不是那个那一种，这一种的饼叫馕。
这个饼比葱油饼
馕不是更蓬一点吗？
而且这个饼。这个饼它基本上是给你那个包那个咖喱酱吃，但其实直接吃也很好吃。对，
台湾有卖那个蒜蓉的。
然后还有要讲，
他那边有大蒜的、奶油的跟 cheese 的什么的，他做很多。
好，
那像那些都超爱，他们做。
下一个。然后主任好像在这里，
是那个Morin 吧？
我是 DK 的。
Morin
DK。
是 DK。
对呀。
Which one？
No, not this one.
That's the Morrison DK.
It's not.
还是
餐桌下面。It's on the table. It was on the table.
He's.
因为我记得是那时候约的主桌，然后他好像坐在这边的最。
He was just on around the table.
这个才比较像 Morrison.
That's very Garfield 的 blue.
Yeah. 哦，他知道这些人。
对。Morrison 在里面的，没有拍到。
Is that Jack? I can't tell.
That's
not the Irish
girl. It's too long. Yeah, he was on the fourth day, so he was telling me where the after party is. Where the third day is not enough, the fourth day is talking about. This
one the most interesting person. This person, the
white
one. We were sitting next to him, and he took the jump, and then cheese, and then everyone started taking pictures, and everyone started looking at the camera, and then said,
"That's who?" Took pictures, and then he was
the waiter.
而且不止一个，来了好几个。
Did you get a picture of Shyamala? Shyamala is she just got elected to the Drupal Associated Board just like last week.
She was at DrupalCon. Yeah, but we haven't.
I mean, there were 800 people. I'm just asking.
Yeah.
然后我们那时候在这个是三楼，然后一楼有很多人在一楼跳舞池，但是我好像那是另外一群人包的。下一个，然后这是我们的 sticker 的交换 stage， 然后那时候我们同时在 有一群的那个亚太区，我们刚好在讨论亚太区的交流。OK， 下一个，那这个是我们在 sprint 第四天的，就是最后一天 sprint， 然后
sprint。
然后他们分了三区，这边看起来人最少，因为这边是
other
base core。对，然后中间这一区有点多，因为它是 other base， 就是你可以自己来的。然后我们在新手区，这个是新手区，
还有更新手，
还有更新手在另外一间，从教你如何开账号，然后用那个什么 SSG
开始做写
程序。
对，
那这不是就有错的事情。
对啊，就是从第一步开始教，
对，
但是就
错
了。对，然后那边教完之后，你就可以过来这边做了。好，下一张。好，这是他有分吗？分上去。我们那时候在这边。
哦，对。
然后他们那个，如果你是第一次的话，他可以在这边，他会教你。然后那时候他们还一边开 IRC， 但其实 IRC 就没什么人在讲话，大家都很专心在。对，然后他后来有一个临时的那个里面是那个反正有一个人是就是开特别去一间教室，然后现场 live 给大家看他们如何打配曲上去这样子。
哦，对，那个是 Webcheek， Webcheek 他那时候就大概两点的时候，他就说请大家可以到另外一间那个教室去。其实他主要的目的是说他做。Live commit到 Drupal Core 里面去的， 所以他就是在那个时候，当这一天其实已经，比如说早上已经有一些人已经先写了一些 patch 上去了。那其实那一活动就是说，他把他挑一两个已经review by community 的东西，那把它直接 commit 到 core 里面去。那这时候主要是目的是说，他告诉大家怎么样，他们是怎么去把这个 code 加到把程式码加到核心的程式里面去的。那同时哪些人可以得到 credit？因为其实 credit 是很蛮重要的，就是说你今天你有贡献，不管你是讨论或是发一个 patch， 这个 patch 可能不是最后被用的，可是你都有机会说你是一个这个 core contributor。所以那天其实就有点是大放送，就是你有去回那个讨论的，那他说没关系，今天大家全部都是 core contributor。OK， 那所以那天他同时会把说实际上有讨论的或者是有写 patch 的人邀请他们上台，然后给他们一些鼓励，然后实际上在大家那边 看他打那个 git 指令把 code push 上去这样子。
OK， 下一个，
好，就是刚才讲的那一个技能表，应该叫做转职数了。转职数就是从最低阶的，然后我们还要照位置排，就这个嘛，然后C 是这一个，那个最左边是一不见了。那张卡包跑哪去了？这张片你可以在网络上直接找到，就是那个卡片在 Google 上的，最下面有一条网址，它最下面有一条网址，你把那个网址打进去就是这几张卡了。对，然后告诉你说每个东西像这个是 community contributor 嘛，叫 documenter 嘛，然后 issue mover 嘛，然后那就是你这边然后可以走向这两个，然后这两个结束之后就可以走向这两个，这样，然后看你等级到什么位置，然后就开始走。然后那天是我们。那个 sprint 已经结束了，然后准备要走，转头一看，一点还是拿起来看，就发现了。好，下一个。然后接下来应该都比较游玩的东西，逛街的是印度。然后我们
就是电视吗？
就是他们类似
一个 mall
吧，的一个 mall。对。然后他基本上就是有卖一些什么衣服啦、啊、杂物啊，然后二楼还有卖吃的这样。哦，这个东西其实很微妙，是我们在日本逛了，
为什么
在
日本？日本在日本，在印度，在印度逛了好几天，看到每只狗都是这个样子，
爽吧？
你只要看到一只狗，它就长这个样子，就躺在路的旁边，长成这个样子。
我觉得这比较不一样，是台湾的，你看到路边有狗躺着的时候，它通常是卷起来的。
而且有
啊、哦，有没有？就是
会有警戒，会警戒。
对，然后或者躺在一个树下，它卷起来。可是他们这边躺的就是直接
躺在树
上，
这叫做没有戒心。
我们还以为我开始还以为他有怕他发生什么事情，没有，结果他有后来看到有一只还很慵懒的转了身睡觉，他在休息的很舒服，每一次都这样。而且他就算在马路边也是这样，他不怕去被人家怎么踢到什么的。下一张。然后这个的话是印度也是有这种，就是你会看到就是有些那种叫很老旧的房子，然后但是旁边又有一栋非常高级的住宅，这样子很容易说还能看得到这种画面。
这个高级住宅中间那一个是什么东西？
中间这个吗？
不是上
面
那
边盖完吗？
还在盖
。
对，那边很多正在盖的。
对，而且
这样可以卖啊！
而且这个东西
密度太高了，不这样盖可能晒不下来。
这个位置是我们已经，我那时候是第四天、第五天了，然后我们就是坐飞机的那个早上，我就去那个南部，他们那个孟买的南边玩。对，然后那时候在坐 Uber 过去这样子，对，然后在路上拍照，所以它已经比较偏南边了。下一张。然后印度其实基本上我不知道它安全性到底算高还是低啦，就是它每个地方只要是人多的景点，然后旅馆、supermarket、学校，全部都有这个东西，全部，而且一定要过。但是很微妙的是，我们后来试着成功了，进大学呢，你只要坐在那个刚才那个嘟嘟车上面，然后呢，他就只给嘟嘟车卡片，就让我们进去了。他连我们的证件都不扫，就为什么？我们还准备拿出来，好，那就过了。
可能是太多了，
我不知道。然后这个是那个他们那个印度门是不是？好像是印度门吧。然后他进去的时候还分两边，男生跟女生，因为男生他会收的比较仔细，女生大概就简单看一看。好，下一个。啊，这印度门，好，下一个。 然后这个东西是他们的那个
剧院，
对，他们的那个电影院，对对对，然后是在这里，因为我要吐槽说，我不知道为什么另外一组他们
啊，对，不
他们去的时候去了宝莱坞看的十四，
看什么？
他们去。那个就是另外一群，就是跳着他们那群去逛第一天的时候，在那边去看 IMAX 的那个 Deadpool，
在印度，
在
印
度
看，因为只要400卢比，折合台币200块，
还好了还好。
然后我就不知道我要去印度看十四，
逛一逛觉得无聊，
高兴吗？
会
有多少啊？
不是让你去那边看十四，也不会看得看得懂吗？你好歹去看个宝莱坞，可以看人家跳舞不是吗？也不说在他们那个电影，你在飞机上就可以看得到。然后我飞机就点了两部来看，从头到尾没看懂，而且完全剧情完全接不起来，就看哎、欸、有人出来了耶跳舞，然后下一段剧情上面这一段剧情跟上面那段剧情没什么关系，也没什么关系，没什么。那第二段演到一半，哎、欸、继续跳舞，等于是这样子。好，下一个，下一张。啊，这个的话，刚才前面那一张比较算是那种，那是什么梦，然后这个的话就是他们比较像
市场
菜市场，类似那种东西，就是各种杂货啊，然后巷子一区游戏，但是这边可以买到很多很便宜的，然后小零食什么东西都很多。好，下一张，然后这是很微妙，它是公车停车，
在那里
等公车的椅子，
但是它。宽度只有这个样子，
大概就这个平板宽，我不知道为什么就走这么大小，
怕人躺在上面。
好，下一张可乐哦。然后后来我们最后离开，然后这是他们那个我们那时候去做那个
孟买机场，
对，然后他们还蛮严的，是你看这边有人嘛。他不是在那边而已哦，每个人进去机票，然后护照全部拿出来看，然后跟你讲说一进去就不能出来。对，所以我们是一下车，然后一进去就不能出来，而且还有一点是他还分门，他还问你坐哪一家的飞机，你这家飞机假如是四号门，就只能从四号门进入，不能从三号门进入。
所以进去里面有厕所吗？
里面有，
这边是都还没有 check in 的，然后你要到 check in 柜台的时候，他们就已经要看你是不是要真的要旅行的，不让你随便进去。
这个是柜台。对，然后那个这边只是进机场的，然后这个栏杆旁边就全部都是那种就是送人下车那些车这样，然后下一张，然后机场样子，里面还有模型车，就把它拍起来了。好，下一张，好，然后如果有人想要在下次还有那个就会看 A 想要又在印度的话，基本上我觉得几率应该不低啊，因为他们。还蛮活跃
在中间，
而且他们还蛮活跃的。其实就是去参加的时候，因为很多的那个 Acura 人在那边，然后他们也工程师的数量和活跃度也偏高这样子。对，那这边的话有一个东西是跟大家分享一个东西，叫印度的签证。那一般来讲，就我们所知，出去签证的话就是旅游签证和商务签证嘛。对，那当然这个的话，这个网址你可以进去看，它是它所有签证种类，但是最特别的是这三个。OK， 然后 business visa 应该不用讲，它是商务签证，大家都知道。然后如果我们要出去玩的话呢，以前我们的方法都是申请签证，然后去那个领事馆那边缴费，然后请他跑流程之后再送签证下来给你。那现在它多一个方法叫做 e-choice， 就是电子的公关签证，就是网络上然后把资料打完，大概要打个30分钟到一小时吧，资料超多的。大概5页还6页、
啊，信用卡也不一定会
对，那信用卡能不能管不晓得，最后是请用户帮我刷的，因为他付费只能用信用卡。如果你在这边打完，然后你不能付费，台湾的领事馆是没办法代收的，你还是只能想办法剩其他信用卡来刷这样。对，那这是观光签证，然后好像只有三个月效用吗？
三个月有效。
对，就是从你那个开通单下开始算起三个月。对，然后一年好像只能申请几次。但是有一点是，我是走这个去的 ，Chris 是走这个去的，这个叫 conference 研讨会签证，这个才是对的，这个才是对的，而且价钱不一样，我这个比较便宜。
没有，其实那真的很 tricky， 就是因为它 他 conference visa 他需要有一些他们官方的一些文件才能去办。那如果你是拿那个 e-tourist visa 的话，理论上他是说你只可以做些比较随性的，你不能是正式或者已经约好的那种 business meeting。所以他那个我就跟他讲说，你绝对不要跟他讲说你要去 conference。所以我就请他还先写了一个大概，比如说旅游
计划书，
以免说
就是如果打开，然后哎、欸、这边有什么景点，开始全部查出来，然后列出来，然后把整一份 Word 带去。
因为其实他们会很严格啦，因为怕说如果那边被退的话，其实就很麻烦了。
啊，你如果是申请 conference 签证，可以去观光吗？
可以，
当然可以啊。
观光等级是最低的，所以你什么签证都可以观光，但是不可以顺便玩是对，但是有这个签证才能做那件事情。所以像我们去 conference， 所以我们就要请 conference 的官方丢证件给你，然后你再拿这个去申请。然后申请的方法不一样，这个就真的要去跑领事馆才能申请，你不能从网络上去打这样子。对，然后但是其实有一点很微妙的是，我是用那个电子观光签证嘛，然后我就拿了那张单子，然后去，然后结果我才准备要走通关、欸，然后要那个通关的那些那个海关啊。这边坐一个，那边坐一个，那边都坐在旁边的椅子上，不是坐在那个通关的那一个座位里面聊天喝茶。然后转过来，
他看过去，他才站。
对，然后我快靠近的时候，才看到有一个人走起来啊，来，然后伸手就把我的那个签证拿过去，然后就看一看，然后他只问我一件事情，your hair is real。
他问他头发是真的，
他问我是头发是不是真的，是不是假发。
对他们来说，留长发比较奇怪。
哎、欸，对，比较不一样。我们要下一张。
我觉得刘海很适合。
真的假的？
真的。
圆脸。好，这个的话呢是待会可能再请那个，不要紧，先回去。那个，好，这个待会可能再请 Chris 再讲解一下。是我们那时候呢，跟一些亚太区的 Jupiter 我们。那时候有跟那个 Sticky 的 Stranger 嘛 ，Stranger， 那这个的话，三个对，好，那后来我们讨论到最后，我们亚太需要怎么交流沟通，所以我们就先开了一个 Slack 的群组，那大家有兴趣跟其他地区的，像什么新加坡啦、香港啦、日本等等之类的 Jupiter 聊天的话呢，交流的话呢，就过来这边申请一下账号。那现在是可以开完就可以直接申请吗？还是这边要打？
我还没有开那个自己邀请
自己
的那个网站。
好，那可能待会晚一点就找 Chris。
那可以直接引拜。
OK， 然后就是打一下你的 email， 然后送一半出去这样子，然后你就可以进来，然后加入聊天。那我们现在还在规划，还不确定什么时候会用，就是有可能之后会有就是跨海的 meeting 之类的，对，还不确定。好，那下一个。那最后的话呢，因为看照片，我只从我的照片里面挑了几张出来。如果你们想看的话呢，点好这个点吧。我把我全部的照片都放在 Google 云端上面，你们可以开始观看。然后 ，OK， 那最后的话呢，给大家看一个很特别的东西，上页，那个这个，他们真的很爱跳舞，所以 video。这个。啊 ，band，
没有，他们都跳舞，
还可以放大，
而且会突然，
这个是第一天开幕结束，然后呢，他就邀请所有人上去一起跳舞，他怎么跳呢？大家看就知道了，不用 iPad 跳，我用 iPad 录，然后第二天开幕以后又跳了一次，受不了，就绕不了。然后后面是这边是歌词，这边是歌词。然后，但我觉得比较强的地方是，你看他们跳一段之后就变成一群一群。
That gal has long hair. The yellow. He grew. He grew guy.
Huh?
Some don't.
Yeah.
Maybe when they get actually went to get married, they might not get that. But until then. But the culture is changing. When is the craziness keep going?
It's not that crazy yet.
No.
I think I can't have a lot of people who are not going to be able to do it. I'm going to be able to do it. I'm going to be able to
do it. I'm
going to be able to do it. I'm going to be able to do it. Just have to know. Like, just enough. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
Alright, so I think it's time for a group photo. So, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's 8:30. Right?
Can we put up the screen?
Yeah, okay.
Alright. I will take like 5 minutes because I need to quickly kind of pop some lights, make sure the lighting's okay, and think about using this space. So, 5 minute break.
Okay.
Cool. And don't forget stickers, come grab them, business cards, come grab them. Kids in here. Actually, you. That's from you. That's from you. All right.
Yeah.
Oh, we can get this to work. You're gonna direct us to stand where?
Oh, in a couple of minutes.
那个
I want to make sure
最后面我写一些他们那边办活动比较特别。
好，可以办。I'm curious what the space kind of looks like before I start doing something.
I'm thinking to make use of that bar up there. Somebody need to hang from there.
我去那边真的换了很多名片，换回来
一整袋，
换回来名片。我那时候瞬间把我的名片盒扫掉放掉，然后公司名片发不够，我就开始发我个人名片。